girls with Embacy Media TV, and I had the fabulous, the lovely, the down to earth, the ambitious Miss Princess Ann Banton. Hi, Princess, how are you?
I'm terrific.
So, you look fabulous for one, might I say. Just a couple questions for you. Being a Canadian woman, what inspired you to create a TV show based around Atlanta Housewives?
That's a great question. For me, it wasn't necessarily, you know, Atlanta. I ended up in Atlanta by chance. So I moved to Atlanta, and when I got here, it just happened to be my new home. So for me to be able to do something that, you know, kind of fell into my lap in Atlanta made sense. So whether I feel like television chose me, I didn't choose television. So I feel like whether I was in Canada, in Toronto, or in Atlanta, it would have happened. It just it ended up being kind of a byproduct of where I, you know, ended up living. So.
And like I was telling you earlier, I am a watcher, a fake watcher of Atlanta Housewives. What do you think are some of the things that Atlanta Housewives brings to reality TV?
Realness. And that's the truth. That's, you know, a lot of people say that.
Definitely.
Well, we're real, and, you know, we like, our show is good because it's real. In this case, I can attest to the fact that it truly is. There's a lot of things in the Atlanta franchise that you don't see in the other franchises.
Yes.
So, you know, I feel like the vulnerability that the women bring, which is when you wear your emotions, whether it's good or bad, on your sleeve, people can relate to that. And when you're not hiding who you are or, you know, being someone else, it really makes a difference in the show. And so Atlanta is real deal Holyfield.
Exactly, yes
they
it is.
They come and bring it.
Yes
bring
it is. It. Like I said, I watch it and it's real. It's real, it's feisty, it's fiery, it's all of that. What are some of the things you like about being behind the camera? What are some of the things you gain from being behind the camera, Princess?
First and foremost, you know, my anonymity. I think that I really truly don't know how those women do it. I feel like even the tiny little bit of you know, I call it FaceTime that you have as a behind the scenes person, that's tough. And so I can't imagine having to live your life where you walk in the airport and you can't walk three steps without somebody trying to talk to you or take your picture. So I think for me, it's definitely a plus to be able to be anonymous behind such a big brand or franchise. You know, and it's being behind the camera is just so. I feel like, you know, when you're in front of the camera, you control your destiny. But when you're behind the camera, you're controlling others' destiny.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's extremely rewarding for me.
Yes, that's awesome. So, I know one of my most memorable moments of Real Housewives of Atlanta is when Phaedra's husband threw Kenya in the pool. And I was back there thinking, oh no, he didn't.
Okay.
So, I want to know, what is your most memorable moment of the Housewives of Atlanta?
Wow, there's been a lot. I think probably, geez, I'm trying to think of all the episodes. You're going to be on the spot.
There's a lot.
There's a lot of moments. I will say one of the moments that I really, you know, I enjoyed seeing because of the backstory. I really enjoyed the reunion show where Kim and Nene hugged and kind of made up.
Yes.
And I'll tell you that was genuine. That was organic. Nobody kind of sat around and thought about it, you know. It just happened. And I think that the fact that they were able to, and they really did cry, and, you know, they were really emotional. It was a very real moment because they have so much history together that really, it totally took me off guard, and it made me extremely proud to know that they were able to be big enough to embrace that moment like that, because it could have went the other way.
Yeah.
Them is just going to be like, hell no, I ain't talking to her, you know, F her. It could have really went like that, but it didn't. It was a really sweet moment. So I loved it.
Yeah. So I would say probably my favorite character on The Real Housewives of Atlanta is Nene. I love Nene. I'm rich. I love all of it.
Yeah.
What was your first impression of Nene?
Wow. I thought that Nene was probably one of the most that moment of meeting her, I, you know, it's funny because a lot of people will ask me about my first, you know, time kind of interviewing her, meeting her, or asking her to be part of the show. She literally opened the door and was like, hi, and she, that's how she greeted me. And she started right away to be an open book. So I knew that Nini was going to be phenomenal and really make the show, help to make the show a hit, and certainly, but I knew that from, I'm telling you, 2 minutes of meeting her, I was like, wow, I think I really have something here with her. So yeah, I always knew. She always did too. She kept telling me that I'm a star. I'm gonna be a star. This, we're gonna do this, princess. And I said, okay.
And she did. She did.
She spoke it, and she's never wavered from her success in being the star that she is. So yeah, this lady.
So princess, I want to thank you so much for coming to the evening program with us. Celebrity Stylist Anthony Henderson, gathering us all here tonight to have a fabulous time. It has been my pleasure and my honor.